One of the problems people have with older Macs is finding operating system disks. It's very common for someone to buy these gray versions from places like eBay, thinking they'll work on their Mac, only to try them out and get a message like this. But I wanted to show you a way to bypass this problem. You may need to use a different Mac. Put in the disk you have, and then go open the disk utility like this. Then select the DVD drive and click New Image. Go ahead and save it to your desktop, and also be sure to pick Read-Write for the image format. This will copy the disk to your desktop. Expect it to take a while. When it's finished, go ahead and eject the real DVD from the drive. Okay, now we need to find out your machine ID. The easiest way to do this is to go to the Utilities folder and open a terminal. Type in sysctl space hw.model. In my case, the model is Mac Mini 1,1. You may want to write this down if yours is different. Okay, so go ahead and open the image and look through the files. Scroll down and find the system folder. Then go into installation. Then packages. Then scroll down and find OS install. What you'll need to do is right click, or you can also do a control click where you hold down the control and click your mouse. Then select Show Package Contents. Next, go into the Contents folder and find OS Install. You'll need to right click this and select Open With, Other, and then locate Text Edit. Now, what you're looking at here where it says Bad Machines are computers which are specifically not allowed. Make sure your model is not listed here. If it is, delete yours from the list. Next, scroll all the way to the bottom and find supported machines. You'll need to add your machine in there. In this case, I'll put Mac Mini 1,1. You may need to unlock the file if it asks. You may want to look through the file and see any other lists of machines and make sure to add yours to the list. When you're done, save the file. Next, dump the mounted image in the trash. Don't worry, this won't delete anything. Okay, next find a suitable dual-layer blank DVD and insert it. Now find the image on the desktop and right-click and select Open with Disk Utility. Once it opens, select the image here and then click Burn. Once it's done burning, you have successfully created a replacement installer disk that should work with your system. Now you can insert it into the machine you want to use it on, and it should work just fine. Okay, so I think I should point out one important aspect of this little trick I've shown you, and that is this is not going to help you run an operating system on your computer that is flat out incompatible. It's only really going to help you in two scenarios. The first scenario is where you've bought a disk that's simply been coded for a different machine. For example, you have a Mac Mini, but you got a restore disk for an iMac. And Apple just, for some reason or another, made those disks so that you couldn't put them on one or the other, even though there's really no technical reason why they won't work. The second scenario that this trick will be useful is that there are some computers where the operating system is actually known to be compatible, but for some reason Apple didn't want to support it, and so they locked out certain older computers. But, you know, if you see on the internet people saying, oh, well, you know, this operating system, even though it isn't officially supported, can be made to work, well, then that's another scenario where this little trick will help you. And so the reason I had to do this little trick was because I wanted to answer a common question that I get asked, which is about OS 10.4 Tiger. People want to know, is it truly obsolete or is it still useful today? Well, I decided I would try to make a video about that, and I had to find a copy of Tiger that would work on an Intel machine because I wanted to run it on this Intel Mac Mini, and I couldn't find one. And so that's why I had to do the little trick. So yeah, I'll be showing you that video probably here in just a few days, and in the meantime, leave me some comments and tell me what you think about this trick. Till next time.